Butt canal consists of vulva, perineum, vagina, cervix, uterus, and gravid ligament. Injury to the vulva. Laceration of the vulval skin, urethral injury. Urethral injury is associated with breast hemorrhage. It should be repaired with intrepid catheter suture, keeping catheter into bladder to avoid urethral injury. Perineum. Injury to the perineum. Gross perineal injury, especially the third and fourth degree, related to the mismanagement of the second stage of the labor. Causes. Overstretching and rapid stretching of inelastic perineum in elderly perineal gravida and patient having history of perineal scar. Classifications of perineal injury. First degree, related to the perineal skin, injury to the perineal skin only. Second degree, injury to the perineal body, not involving the anal sphincter. Second degree. Third degree, injury to the perineum involving the anal sphincter complex, both external and internal. And fourth degree is related to the injury to the perineum involving anal sphincter complex and anal epithelium. Kono kichu na bujhle jiggesh korbe, please. Risk factors for third degree perineal in tear. Patients having big baby, more than 3 kg, nullipara, outlet of contraction with narrow pubic arch, shoulder dystocia, forceps delivery, scar in perineum, race to pubis delivery, midline episiotomy, and precipitate labor. What is the management of the perineal tear? Perineal tear should be managed with local repair, if necessary, anesthesia. We always use a local anesthesia. Vaginal injury. Isolated vaginal tear or laceration without involvement of perineum or cervix is not uncommon. Usually seen following instrumental or manipulative delivery. Tears are repaired by interrupted or continuous suture as necessary. Tears with brisk hemorrhage require repair and exploration under general anesthesia. Colporhexis. এখানে অনেক টার্ম তোমাদের কাছে নতুন হয়তো প্রয়োজনে জিজ্ঞেস করব. Colporhexis means rupture of the vault of the vagina is called colporhexis. It may be primary or secondary. Colporhexis commonly involves posterior fornix of the vagina. Secondary colporhexis is usually associated with cervical tear and associated with lateral fornix involvement. Treatment. If tear is limited to the vault close to the cervix, repair is done from below. If cervical tear extends to the lower segment or major branches involving major branches of different vessels, then laparotomy should be done with simultaneous resuscitative measure. Injury to the cervix. Cervical tear is commonest cause of traumatic PPH. Usually, left tear is most common. Causes of cervical tear, it may be iatrogenic or due to some other causes. Iatrogenic, following forceps delivery or breech extraction through incompletely dilated cervix. Rigid cervix, scarred cervix following history of operation like cervical operation like amputation of the cervix, colonization, cervical lesion like carcinoma cervix, strong uterine contraction in precipitate labor or in vascular cervix in like percent of repair. Cervical detachment, it may be annular or it may involve anterior leg of the cervix. Annular detachment means when it involves entire circumference of the cervix following prolonged labor with cervical dystocia. Anterior leg of the cervix detachment can occur when cervix is nipped in between the fetal head and symphysis pubis. Diagnosis. Excessive vaginal bleeding immediately following delivery in presence of hard and contracted uterus raises suspicion of cervical tear. Management. Repair should be done under general anesthesia in lithotomy position with good light. What are the dangers associated with cervical tear? Early dangers are deep subacute tears involving major vessels lead to severe PPH, broad ligament hematoma, pelvic cellulitis, thrombophlebitis. Late dangers are ectropion, cervical incompetence with mid-trimester aversion. Pelvic hematoma. Collection of blood anywhere in the area between the pelvic peritoneum and perineal skin is called hematoma. Types. Depending on the relation to the levator ani, it may be infralevator, which is below the levator ani, and it is the most common, and supralevator, which is above the levator ani, it is rare. Etiology of the intralevator hematoma. Commonly, we term is a vulval hematoma. It is most common in clinical practice, vulval hematoma. Infralevator hematoma etiology are improper hemostasis during repair of vaginal or perineal tear or repair of episiotomy wound. তোমরা যেটা ইন্টারনি হয়ে গেলে কমনলি পাবে সেটা হচ্ছে যে এইরকমই যে ফেলিওর টু সুচার দ্য অ্যাপেক্স ফেলিওর টু অবলিটারেট দ্য ডেড স্পেস অ্যান্ড রাপচার দ্য প্যারাভাজাইনাল ভেনাস প্লেক্সাস স্পন্টেনিয়াসলি অর ফলোইং ইনস্ট্রুমেন্টাল ডেলিভারি. What will be the complaints of the patient? A patient just delivered or history of recent delivery with persistent and severe pain on the perineum, rectal tenesmus or bearing down effect. When you will examine the patient, you will see on general examination there is variable degree of shock, and on local examination it tends swelling at the vulva, which is dusky and purple color and tender to touch. What will be the treatment? If there is associated shock, you should manage the shock. And small hematoma usually not associated with shock. And in that, if it is less than 5 cm, then centimeter, then it may be treated conservatively. Larger hematomas should be explored under general anesthesia with simultaneous resuscitation. Supralevator hematoma causes are extension of the cervical laceration or primary colporexy, lower segment rupture, spontaneous rupture of paravaginal venous flexures. Acha tumra shobai, hello,
ji ma'am,
unexplained diagnosis, unexplained shock with features of internal hemorrhage following delivery raises suspicion of supralevator hematoma. If you examine the patient on abdominal examination, you will find a swelling above the inguinal ligament of the lower abdomen, pushing the uterus to the contralateral side. On vaginal examination, there will be occlusion of the vaginal canal by a bulge, bogy swelling felt through the fornix. On rectal examination, presence of a bogy mass. Investigation if needed, if time allows you, then you can do an ultrasonogram to localize the hematoma, manage it. Resuscitation and laparotomy should be side by side. Rupture of the uterus. Actually, in obstetric ward, you will commonly find injury due to vulva, perineal injury like first degree, second degree, third degree, fourth degree, perineal tear. Vulval hematoma, among the hematoma, you commonly find it in faces and then the rupture occurs. Cervical tear and then the rupture occurs. It is the most important cause of maternal death in obstetrics. Rupture in the continuity of the all uterine layers, including endometrium, myometrium, and cerosa. Anytime beyond 28 weeks of pregnancy is called rupture uterus. 28 সপ্তাহ পরে ইউটারাসের তিনটা লেয়ারই রাপচার হয়ে যাবে, ডিসকন্টিনিউ হবে, সেটাকে আমরা রাপচার ইউটারাস বলছি. আমাই ক্লিয়ার? টাইপস, ইট মে বি কমপ্লিট রাপচার, ইনকমপ্লিট রাপচার. ওয়েন ফলোয়িং ডিসরাপশন অফ দ্য স্কার ইন আপার সেগমেন্ট অর Complete rupture may be due to spontaneous rupture of both obstructive and non-obstructive types. Incomplete rupture. It usually results from rupture of the lower segment scar or extension of cervical tear into the lower segment with formation of broad ligament hernia. According to cause, rupture it was may be spontaneous rupture, scar rupture, or iatrogenic rupture. Spontaneous rupture during pregnancy is usually complete, meaning interlayering rupture hobe, involves usually in the upper segment and occurs in the later months of the pregnancy. Causes: history of previous damage to the uterine wall during dilatation and puberty, manual removal of placenta, also in grand mal tubera due to thin uterine wall, congenital malformation like bicornal uterus or in cobular uterus. Spontaneous rupture in labor. Obstructive type. Obstructive rupture, it is the end result of obstructed labor. Rupture involves usually the lower segment and extends laterally to the side of the uterus to the upper segment. Non-obstructive rupture usually occurs in the grand mal tubera due to the weakening of the uterine wall as a result of repeated childbirth. You know that when repeated childbirth, few myometrial fibers replaced by fibrous tissue, which make the uterus weak. Usually involves the fundal area and it is complete intact. Then the scar rupture. Incidence of the scar rupture is very important to know. Lower segment scar rupture is about 1 to 2%. Classical scar, cesarean scar. যেটাকে না upper segment is cesar incision দিয়ে cesar করা হয় সেটাকে আমরা classical cesar incision বলি. Classical cesar incision and hysterotomy scar. Rupture is 5 to 10 times more higher than the lower segment scar. Uterine scar in non-pregnant uterus following myomectomy or metroplasty hardly rupture. Uterine scar in non-pregnant uterus following myomectomy or metroplasty hardly rupture. কারণ uterus non-pregnant থাকে scar healing ভালো হয়. During pregnancy, classical cesarean section and hysterotomy scar is likely to give way during later months of the pregnancy following weakness of such or weakening of such scar is due to implantation of the placenta over the scar and increased vascularity. সাধারণত placenta implantation হয় upper segmentে, যদি classical cesarean section or hysterotomy করা হয় সেক্ষেত্রে placenta অনেক সময় ওই scar-এ implantation হয়ে যায় এবং scar-টা weak হয়ে যায়, vascularity হয়ে যায়, vascularity বেড়ে যায়. Lower segment scar rarely ruptures during pregnancy. Scar rupture during labor. Classical cesarean section scar or hysterotomy scar, corneal dissection of ectopic pregnancy is more vulnerable to scar rupture during labor. Although rare, lower segment scar predominantly rupture during labor. Now, iatrogenic or traumatic rupture, যেটা আমাদের ডাক্তারদের জন্য হচ্ছে সেটা. During pregnancy, injudicious use of oxytocin or use of prostaglandin for induction of labor or abortion. Possible external version, especially during general anesthesia, especially done when done under general anesthesia or blow or fall on the abdomen. During labor, iatrogenic ruptures are due to internal podalic version following obstructed labor, manual removal of the placenta, application of forceps or breech extraction through incompletely dilated cervix, injudicious use of oxytocin or for augmentation of labor. Clinical features. During pregnancy, patient will present in case of scar rupture. Patient will give you a history of cesarean section, either classical or lower segment. or hysterectomy. Patient will pump in dull abdominal pain over the scar associated with slight vaginal bleeding, sense of something giving way with acute abdominal pain and collapse. On abdominal palpation, you will find tenderness over the uterus and fetal heart sound may be irregular or absent. Scar rupture during is a spontaneous rupture in uninjured uterus, usually confined to the highly perus only, may be acute or insidious in onset. In acute types, acute abdominal pain with fainting attack and collapse. On examination, you will find features of shock, abdominal palpation, acute tenderness over the uterus, and fetal parts will be superficial, will palpate easily, absence of the fetal ulcer. In insidious onset, it will present like that of features of accidental hemorrhage. You may confuse with accidental hemorrhage. Rupture following blow or use of oxytocin or external version. Usually have history of such an accident and acute pain in abdomen associated with slight vaginal bleeding. On examination, there will be rapid pulse, tender uterus, and it will also confused with accidental hemorrhage and confirmation done by laboratory. During labor, scar rupture, same features will be same as during the pregnancy. Onset is usually acute in hysterectomy and classical scar rupture. Insidious in onset, in lower segment scar rupture. It is called silent rupture and confirmation done by laboratory. Spontaneous obstructive rupture. Patient is usually multipara with features of obstruction. Initially, pain becomes severe and comes at frequent intervals in an attempt to overcome the obstruction. Gradually, pain becomes continuous and mainly confined to the suprapubic region. On general examination, patient will be dehydrated and exhausted, pulse will be rapid, and temperature is raised. On abdominal examination, lower segment will be distended, bladder will be distended, and there will be bundles ring usually visible. Fetal heart sound may be irregular or absent. On vaginal examination, you will find vagina dry, hot, edematous, and presenting part is jammed in the vagina. In the phase of rupture, there will be a sense of something giving way at the height of uterine contraction, and there will be constant pain, change to dull, acute pain, with cessation of the uterine contraction. On examination, features of shock and exertion. On abdominal examination, absence of uterine contour, and you will find two separate swelling on the abdomen, one due to contracted uterus and another due to fetal abort. Fetal parts will be superficial, absence of the fetal heart sound. On the general examination, general bleeding and recession of the presenting part. Spontaneous non-obstructive rupture, solely rare and confined to the highly perus women. Patient is suddenly seized with an agonizing bursting pain at the height of uterine contraction, followed by relief with cessation of the contraction. Diagnostic features, there will be features of shock, evidence of internal, features of internal hemorrhage, tenderness over the uterus and vaginal bleeding. Rupture following manipulative or instrumental delivery. Such sudden deterioration of the general condition of the patient, variable amount of vaginal bleeding following instrumental or manipulative delivery. Shortening of the cord immediately following a difficult vaginal delivery is pathognomic to uterine rupture. I repeat, shortening of the cord immediately following a difficult vaginal delivery is pathognomic to heat when rupture. As placenta being extruded out into the abdominal cavity through the rent in the uterus. Exploration of the uterus to fill the rent confirms the diagnosis. Management. Prophylaxis, magnetic prevention. Rupture uterus is almost always preventable. In an antenatal checkup, if we can find the high-risk patient or at-risk mother and counsel them for mandatory hospital delivery, or in intranatal care, that is during delivery, labor and delivery, if we become conscious and careful, then we can prevent most of the rupture uterus. Following guidelines are helpful to prevent or to detect rupture uterus early. Those at-risk mother like patient with contracted pelvis, patient with history of cesarean section or other surgery in uterus, grand mal tipara, patient known case with hydrocephalus, should have mandatory hospital delivery. You must counsel the patient during your antenatal care. In external version, GA should be avoided to give undue pressure. Undue delay in progress of labor in multipara. Injudicious selection of cases with history of cesarean section for vaginal birth after cesarean section. Injudicious selection of cases and watch are mandatory. Judicious selection of cases and watch are mandatory during oxytocin infusion, either for induction or augmentation of labor. There is hardly any place of internal pleural version in singleton pregnancy in present day. Cesarean section can be done as an alternative. Attempted forceps delivery or breech extraction through incompletely dilated cervix should be avoided. Destructive vaginal operation should be done by skilled person and exploration of the uterus is a must following delivery. As a routine practice, manual removal of the placenta in morbid adhesion of placenta should be done by senior person. Treatment. Resuscitation and laparotomy both should be done simultaneously. Laparotomy followed by resuscitation. Laparotomy followed by hysterectomy, repair of uterus or repair and sterilization. Hysterectomy is the hysterectomy means removal of the uterus. Hysterectomy is the surgery for the ruptured uterus unless there is a sufficient reason to preserve the uterus. It is preferable to perform a quick subtotal hysterectomy rather than a total hysterectomy. Repair should be mostly applicable to the scar rupture where margins are clean. Repair and sterilization. This is mostly done in patient with scar rupture having clean cut margin with desired number of children. Visceral injuries. Along with rupture uterus, visceral injuries are not uncommon. Among them, bladder injury is mostly common. Obstetrical injury to the bladder may be due to traumatic or sloughing fistula. Traumatic may be due to instrumental vaginal delivery such as destructive operation or following forceps delivery. Then abdominal operation such as hysterectomy for rupture uterus or cesarean section. Sloughing fistula. It results from prolonged compression effect on the bladder. When bladder is compressed between the fetal head and synthesis is this in obstetric level. It is due to ischemia of the bladder tissue. Diagnosis. Traumatic fistula or traumatic injury to the bladder is associated with dribbling out of urine soon following operative delivery, bloodstained urine, colon cesarean section or hysterectomy is suggestive of bladder injury. Meaning cesar korle othoba vaginal cesar korlo hysterectomy korlo pore jokhon dekha gelo sathe sathe dribbling of urine hocche othoba urine ta blood mix tokhon mone hoy je eta traumatic injury bladder injury. In that case, usually margins are clear, clean cut with oozing surface. And sloughing fistula, patient has history of prolonged labor or obstructed labor, and dribbling of urine occurs after varying interval of delivery, usually 12 to 7 weeks. After the delivery, patient develops dribbling of urine. Margins are devitalized and necrosed, and there is missing of chunk of the tissue, except portion of the tissue absent pathic. Slough pattern. Management. Traumatic fistula. Immediate local repair. With a clean cut, fresh, and local repair for the in unfavorable condition when self-retaining catheterization is to be introduced and to be kept for 14 days and urinary antibiotic should be given. In favorable condition, there may be spontaneous closure of the fistula if it is small. If it fails, then repair is to be done after 3 months. Sloughing fistula. Self-retaining catheter should be done and urinary antibiotic should be given. Repair should be done after 3 months. Rectal injury. Rectal injury is very rare in obstetrics. Why? Because middle portion of the rectum, middle third of the rectum is supported by hollow of the sacrum. Curve of the sacrum at the middle portion is protect the rectum, and the upper portion of the rectum is protected by peritoneal reflection. The anatomy monocotte param the peritoneal reflection from the posterior of the uterus to the rectum. Ekhane ekta gap thake, oi gap er jonno she upper part ke protect kore ebong sacrum je curvature middle third the middle portion of the rectum ke middle third the rectum ke protect kore. Still then there may be rectovaginal fistula. Rectovaginal fistula prolonged compression of the rectum by the fetal head in mid pelvic contraction with a flat sacrum predisposes to ischemic necrosis of the interior rectal wall and results in RBF. যেরকম ব্লাডারে হচ্ছিল স্লাফিং ফিস্টুলা, রেক্টামে এইরকম ফিস্টুলা হয় যখন প্রলং লেবার এন্ড প্রলং কম্প্রেশন অফ দ্য রেক্টাম. রিপেয়ার শুড বি পোস্টপোন ফর এট লিস্ট 3 মান্থস. অ্যানাদার রেক্টাল ইঞ্জুরি ইজ কমপ্লিট পেরিনিয়াল টিয়ার উইথ ইঞ্জুরি টু দি অ্যানাল মিউকোসা. অ্যানাস অ্যান্ড রেক্টাম স্ট্যান্ডার্ড অ্যাপ্রোচ হয়ে যায় তাহলে ইঞ্জুরি টু দি অ্যালং উইথ দি ইঞ্জুরি টু দি কমপ্লিট পেরিনিয়াল. Urethral injury, not so uncommon. It may be due to traumatic resulting from instrumental delivery or ischemic sloughing. Principles of management are similar to the use of that of bladder injury. কোনো প্রশ্ন আছে কিছু বলতে চাও? কোনো স্লাইড নিয়ে কিছু বুঝে নাই বা কোনো টার্ম বুঝে নাই?
ম্যাডাম, অক্সিটোসিনের প্রোস্টাগ্ল্যান্ডিন দিয়ে যে আপনি বলছিলেন যে যে আয়াট্রোজেনিক যে রাপচারটা হয়, হ্যাঁ এটা একটু কাইন্ডলি আরেকবার যদি কেন হয় সেটা যদি।
ওকে, অক্সিটোসিন যদি ইনজুডিশিয়াস ইউজ, এই কথাটা খেয়াল করতে হবে, ইনজুডিশিয়াস ইউজ মানে তুমি অক্সিটোসিন দিয়ে তো আমরা লেভার অগমেন্ট করি, অনেক সময় লেভার ইনিশিয়েট করি, প্রোস্টাগ্ল্যান্ডিন দিয়ে আমরা সার্ভিস রাইট করি, এসব ক্ষেত্রে যদি ইনজুডিশিয়াস ইউজ মানে তুমি যে ডোজে অ্যাপ্রোপ্রিয়েট ডোজে দেওয়ার কথা তার চেয়ে বেশি ডোজ দিয়ে দিয়েছো, এবার খুব রেপিড দিয়ে দিচ্ছে, যেটা একটা নির্দিষ্ট লিমিট আছে, এর বাইরে চলে গেলে তখন সাস্টেইন এন্ড ভায়োলেন্ট ইউটেরাইন কন্ট্রাকশন লিমিট টু আপটু, বুঝতে পারছি।
জি ম্যাম,
আর কারো কিছু জানা আছে? বুঝা গেছে কিনা কিছু জানা আছে? একজনই কথা বলতেছে, বাকিরা আছো কিভাবে বুঝবো? কেউ কথা বলে না, কারো কোনো প্রশ্ন নাই? প্রশ্ন নাই মানে কি সব বুঝছো? আমার তো মনে হয় অবস্ট্যাটিক্যালি টার্ম গুলো তোমাদের কাছে নতুন, অনেক টার্ম নতুন, কেউ কিছু জানতে চাইলে বুঝতে না পারলে প্লিজ জিজ্ঞাসা করে, পরে আবার টিউটরের কাছে বলতে পারবো না বুঝো নাই। কারো কোনো প্রশ্ন নাই মানে সবাই বুঝতে পারছে? আচ্ছা তাহলে একজন বলো তোমরা কি কি ইয়ার ইনজুরি কমন পাবা? আমি একটু আগে বলছি লেবার রুমে তুমি ডিউটি করছো, কি কি ইনজুরি কমন পাবা? সময় বেশিক্ষণ নাই, বলো একজন বলো। সাদিয়া, সাদিয়া বলো দেখি কি কি ইনজুরি কমনলি পাবা লেবার রুমে? আমি বললাম
ম্যাম, সার্ভাইকাল ইনজুরি, তারপরে ইউরেথ্রা।